Reversal operation of the continuous time signal is of two types, time reversal and amplitude reversal. So in this lecture, you will understand what is the time reversal operation of the continuous time signal and some example based on the time reversal operation of the continuous time signal. We know that a continuous time signal, or CTS, is a function of independent variable t, and it is defined for all the values of this independent variable t. So continuous time signal can be represented by xt, where x is the dependent variable and t is the independent variable. This time reversal operation of the continuous time signal is a signal processing operation that flips the signal xt about the y-axis, or time reverse signal is the reflection of the signal xt about the vertical line. In this operation, independent variable t is replaced by minus t, and this is also known as the folding operation of the signal xt. Mathematically, it can be shown as yt is equal to x of kt, where k is equal to minus 1, or we can write yt is equal to x of minus t. So this is one type of time scaling operation where the signal xt is scaled by a value of minus 1. Let's consider a system which does the time reversal. So input to this system is the signal xt, and the output of the system will be yt, which is the time reverse version of the input signal xt, or yt is equal to x of minus t. Let's see an example to understand this time reversal operation. Now, the condition for the time reversal operation of the signal xt is yt is equal to x of kt, where k is equal to minus 1. So we have to plot the signal yt is equal to x of minus t. Now we will make a table for observing the different values of the signal xt at different time instant. Let's take a signal xt. When the time t is greater than or equal to minus 1 and less than 0, then the value of the signal xt is equal to 1. When the time t is greater than or equal to 0 and less than 2, then the value of the signal xt is equal to 2. When the time t is equal to 3, then the value of the signal xt is equal to 0. To perform the time reversal, we have to flip the signal xt about y-axis. So the time interval of the signal xt will be completely reversed. The time interval t is greater than or equal to minus 1 and less than 0 will become t is greater than or equal to 0 and less than 1, and the value of the signal yt will be equal to xt for the interval, or the value of the signal yt is equal to 1. And the time interval t is greater than or equal to 0 and less than 2 will become t is greater than or equal to minus 2 and less than 0, and value of the signal yt will remain same, or it is equal to 2. And finally, t is equal to 3 will become t is equal to minus 3, and the value of the signal yt will be equal to xt, or it will be equal to 0. So this is the time reverse version of the signal xt, which is simply achieved by replacing the time t in the signal xt by minus t in the signal yt. And if we take a look at this time reverse signal yt, then we can see that the amplitude and the duration of the signal does not change. Only change is that the signal xt is flipped about y-axis, hence the time reversal operation of the signal xt takes place. Now let's take another example. This signal has the value from t is equal to minus 3 to t is equal to 0. To perform this time reversal, we just simply revert the signal about the time-axis, where this t is equal to minus 3, minus 2 and minus 1 will become t is equal to 3, 2 and 1. And so this is the time reverse version of the signal xt, where t is replaced by minus t, as t is equal to minus 3 here of the signal xt is replaced by t is equal to 3 in the signal yt. This concludes our discussion for this lecture. In the event that you have any question regarding this presentation, feel free to post them in the comment section, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.